Welcoming Tracy to the Hall of Fame is Isaiah Thomas. Ladies and gentlemen, Tracy McGrady.
Yes, yes. Man. Yes, thank you guys, appreciate it. Zeke, I don't know what you saw, brother, but back in 1997, you recognized my talent, scrawny 18-year-old coming out of high school. I appreciate that. I appreciate you having me fulfill my childhood dream by drafting me ninth overall. That meant the world to me. And the first year didn't go so well. The first half of that year didn't go so well, as you know. But you went on, became an excellent coach. You did some great things as an executive, made some great moves. But your best move, Zeke, was firing that coach my rookie year. Firing that coach my rookie year that criticized me, said I wasn't going to be in the league beyond 3 years. Was he wrong? Boy, was he wrong. Boy, was he wrong. Back in February, my wife and I were on our way to the Hall of Fame finalist press conference at this year's All-Star Weekend in New Orleans. We were on the elevator, and she kept telling me how proud of me she was and asked me if I was excited. I remained nonchalant, never really showed too much emotion, or at least not the level of emotion that she was expecting. Sensing the real truth behind what my hesitation and non-emotion demeanor was really about, she told me to repeat after her and say, I deserve to be in the Hall of Fame. I didn't say a word. She insisted. This time she said, look in the mirror that was on the elevator wall and repeat after me. I deserve to be in the Hall of Fame. Now, I still couldn't let those words utter from my mouth. Don't get me wrong. It wasn't because I wasn't excited or honored. However, truth be told, I didn't want to allow myself to get too excited. You see, my wife knew something about me in that elevator that I had yet to admit and say out loud. There was a reason she wanted me to look myself in that mirror and say I deserved to be in the Hall of Fame. And there was also a reason why I couldn't do it. In those split moments that she asked me to state out loud that I deserved to be in the Hall of Fame, I had a zillion thoughts in my mind why I didn't deserve to be it. I started thinking of all these NBA greats who had accomplished so many great things. And then I began comparing myself to them. It's way too easy to focus on what you don't have and what you didn't accomplish. But I'm grateful for those people that saw in me and believed in me, just maybe when I always didn't believe in myself. People who actually saw the man and not just the athlete. One thing I've learned in those 15 years of playing is the power of perseverance, faith, and pushing through even when the odds are against you. Even when they said you wouldn't last 3 years in the league. Even when your work ethic was criticized. And even when you come from nothing and enter into the amazing world of the NBA without a name, without a track record, and without any proof that you deserve a chance. I'm grateful for God for blessing me with amazing gift and talent and entrusting me with it. In addition, I can't leave this stage without thanking the NBA. You have sent me to places around the world I never knew existed. Just a small town kid from Arbondale, Florida, that traveled the world a few times and in my life became richer with everybody I met along the way. Thank you to Adidas. I'm proud of what we accomplished together. We sold a ridiculous amount of shoes, and we're not done yet. We're not done yet. Thank you to every basketball organization I ever played for, every coach I played for, Doc Rivers, Butch Carter, I appreciate you guys. And to the fans, both in the States and around the world, forever loyal, never stop believing in me. You gave me way more than I ever can give you. I am so grateful for all of my teammates, but I have to highlight those teammates who have impacted my life and made me a much better basketball player. Thank you, Yao Ming, Dikembe Mutombo, Grant Hill, Darrell Armstrong, Doug Christie, Vince Carter, D. Brown, Charles Oakley, Muggsy Bogues, Kevin Willis, Jermaine O'Neal, Dale Curry, and Antonio Davis. And to the realest coach I ever played for, he's not here tonight, he couldn't make it, he's back home helping some flood victims back in Houston, Coach Jeff Van Gundy. I just wish we had the opportunity to play a few more years. Johnny Davis, thank you very much for allowing me to work with you and giving me the footwork. My shooting coach in my Toronto days, Jim Thomas, Sonny, and Pam Vaccaro. Back in 1996, going to that camp, being the last guy to enter this camp, and you give me that jersey, 175. Nobody had a clue who Tracy McGrady was. You gave me that platform. And I played against the best players in the world at that time. And I left that camp the number one player in the nation. From 175 to number one, thank you, Sonny and Pam. To my financial team, it's gonna be all right, Sonny. To my financial team, thank you guys. Made a lot of money in my playing career, and you don't care of it. I appreciate that. To my agent, Arn Tellum, Bob Myers, thank you guys. To my attorney, Tim Hoy, I appreciate you. My assistant, Elisa Grable, 20 years, thank you for organizing my life and my family's life. So all of my family, my siblings and friends, my brothers and sisters that are here, I thank you guys, I appreciate you. Mom and grandmother, two women that kept me out of the streets of a drug-infested neighborhood. The one thing my grandmother instilled in me was patience. While all the other kids were out playing, I had to leave the house in the wee hours in the morning to go fishing with you for 12 hours. Being on that lake, bonding with my grandmother taught me patience, endurance, and the ability not to sweat what I couldn't control. And you know one thing that you always did, who was on that boat, whenever you wanted the beer, what was your sign? To my mom, always my biggest cheerleader, coming to all my games, and you were being the absolute loudest person in the gym. And even when I was a professional, you was the loudest person in the gym, and 20,000 people, I hear your voice. Thank you very much. But what you taught me is not to be that to my kids, so I appreciate that. Until my four beautiful kids, Layla, Lacey, Layman, Layden, remember this, your character is always much more significant than your reputation. Never forget who you are. Never forget that, and that you belong to God. You belong to God. Because who you are in secret is just as important who you are in public. Why? Because God sees both. Don't forget that. To my wife, who I've been with for 20 years, God has given me a woman that has proven to be a beautiful mother, a wonderful wife, an amazing friend, and I thank God for you every single day. I love you. Now back to that elevator story I was telling you about. Although what I couldn't do, what my wife requested of me 7 months ago, and tell myself in that mirror that I deserve to be in the Hall of Fame, well, on this day, I can proudly say, yes, I deserve to be here. I am truly humbled, I'm grateful, and proud to be in the class of 2017. Thank you very much.